Now we will see the matrices for operators J plus, J minus, Jx and Jy. First we will see the matrices for J plus and J minus. We know that the eigenstate is given by ket Jm. So Jz Jm is equal to M h bar Jm. Jz J M plus 1. This will be M plus 1 H bar J M plus 1. Now take the eigenvector J plus J M. If the ket J M is an eigenvector of J Z with the eigenvalue M H bar, then J plus J M is also an eigenvector of J Z with the eigenvalue raised by 1, eigenvalue raised by h bar or quantum number raised by 1. So it is Jz J plus ket Jm equal to M plus 1 h bar J plus Jm. When we see these two equations, they are identical. Here we are getting M plus 1 h bar, here also we are getting M plus 1 h bar. So we can say that this eigenket is equivalent to that eigenket. The J plus ket Jm is equivalent to ket Jm plus 1. So we can write J plus Jm, it is equivalent to ket Jm plus 1. These two are equivalent. At the most, they can differ by a multiplying factor. I am writing that that multiplying factor as Am. So these two eigenkets are identical, and we can write the ket, the J plus ket Jm is equal to a constant Am into Jm plus 1. I am taking this as equation number 1. In a similar way, we can write J minus Jm. J minus Jm, it is identical to Jm minus 1. So here I am taking the multiplying factor as Bm. So this is equation number 2. So J plus Jm is Am J M plus 1. Since J plus ket Jm and ket Jm plus 1 are identical vectors, they are having same eigenvalue when we operate with Jz. Similarly, in a similar way, J minus Jm equal to Bm J M minus 1. Now, for finding the matrix elements of J plus, I am multiplying on left by bra J prime M prime. J prime M prime, multiplying on left of this equation 1, we get J plus J M is equal to, A M is constant, so A M J prime M prime J M plus 1. So this is J prime M prime J plus J M equal to A M J prime M prime J M plus 1. This we can write it as A M delta J prime J delta M prime M plus 1. So on the right hand side, we will be getting non-vanishing terms only when J prime equal to J and M prime equal to M plus 1. So when J prime equal to J, this left hand side we can write it as J, then M prime equal to M plus 1. So left hand side J, M plus 1, J plus J M is equal to right hand side J prime equal to J. So this will be 1, then M prime equal to M plus 1, this one will be 1. So we will be getting Am. I am writing this as equation 3. J M plus 1 J plus J M equal to Am. Now this equation 2 on left hand side, I am multiplying with the J prime M prime. So I will be getting J prime M prime J minus J M equal to, instead of Am we are having Bm, then J prime M prime J M minus 1. Now this equation we can write it as Bm delta J prime J delta M prime m minus 1. This will be having non-vanishing right hand side only when m prime equal to m minus 1. If m prime equal to j prime equal to j, m prime equal to m minus 1, this equation can be written as ket j m minus 1 j minus j m is equal to right hand side we are having b m. This equation, I am writing it as equation 4. Now, I take the complex conjugate of this equation 3. Taking the conjugate of equation 3 from equation 3, taking the conjugate of this one, I can write it as AM conjugate equal to, taking the conjugate, the bra vector will become ket and ket vector will become bra. Then this operator, taking the conjugate of J plus operator, J plus is actually jx plus ijy. So j plus conjugate will be jx minus ijy, which is j minus. Similar way, j minus its conjugate, jx minus ijy conjugate, it will be plus. So it will be j plus. So taking the conjugate of equation 3, we will get am conjugate equal to this ket vector will become bra vector, bra jm, then j plus will become j minus, then this bra vector will become ket vector. Taking the conjugate, bra vector becomes ket vector and ket vector becomes bra vector. This bra vector becomes ket vector, so it is j m plus 1. So this one is equation 5. Now, taking the conjugate of equation 4, we will be getting bm star is equal to conjugate jm left, it will be this ket jm will be bra jm, then j minus will be j plus, then j m minus 1, that bra vector will be will become ket vector j m minus 1. So this is equation number 6. From this equation 1, equation 1 is j plus jm equal to am jm m plus 1. So here I am replacing m by, it is j plus jm, here we are having j plus jm minus 1. So this m I am replacing by m minus 1. Replacing m by m minus 1 in equation 1. Equation 1 left. In this equation, I replace m by m minus 1. So, it will be j plus j m minus 1 is equal to right hand side a m is replaced by m minus 1. So, it is a m minus 1, then j, this m is replaced by m minus 1. So, it is m minus 1 plus 1. So, it is a m minus 1 j m. Now, I am multiplying by bra jm on left. So when we multiply bra jm on left, it will be jm j plus jm minus 1 equal to am minus 1 jm jm. What is the value of this one? Delta jj delta mm. So that will be equal to 1. So this we will be getting as am minus 1 equal to jm j plus jm minus 1, which is same as equation 6, right hand side of equation 6. So from equation 6 and 7 we can write it as am minus 1 equal to bm star, am minus 1 equal to bm star. In a similar way, this j minus jm, j minus, here it is j m plus 1. So here the m I replace by m plus 1. If I replace m by m plus 1, this equation becomes equation 2. I am replacing m by m plus 1. So this will become j minus j m plus 1 is equal to j minus j m plus 1 equal to b m is replaced by m plus 1, bm plus 1, then get j, m is replaced by m plus 1. So it is m plus 1 minus 1. So it is bj. Now, it is j minus get j m plus 1. J minus get j m plus 1. Left, from left I am multiplying by ket jm. So if I multiply by ket jm from left, ket jm j minus j m plus 1 equal to b m plus 1 bra jm ket jm. So I am multiplying by bra jm from left. So it will be like this. This one will be delta jj delta mm. So that will be equal to 1. So we will be getting b m plus 1 equal to j m j minus j m plus 1. J m j minus j m plus 1. That means a m star. So we will be getting b m plus 1. B m plus 1 equal to a m star. B m plus 1 equal to a m star. Now in this equation, I am operating with j minus. So it is j minus j plus jm is equal to am, then j minus jm plus 1. J minus jm plus 1. J minus jm is equivalent to bm jm minus 1. This eigenvector, contour number decreases by 1 and the constant is bm. Here instead of jm we are having jm plus 1. So replace this m by m plus 1. Then we will be getting j minus jm plus 1 equal to bm plus 1 j. M plus 1 minus 1 means m. That means instead of this, the right hand side it is am j minus j m plus 1. J minus j m plus 1. This m should be replaced by m plus 1. Then it will be b m plus 1. Then b m plus 1. Then j m should be replaced by m plus 1. So m plus 1 minus 1 means m. So we will be getting am b m plus 1 j m on the right hand side. Left hand side, left hand side it is j minus j plus. What is j minus j plus? J minus j plus equal to jx minus ijy into jx plus ijy. It is jx square plus jy square, then minus ijy jx plus ijx jy. So we can write minus I commutator jy jx is equal to jx square plus jy square. Jx square plus jy square plus jz square is j square. So this one we can write it as j square minus jz square. Then minus I into jx jy is I h bar jz. Here it is jy jx. So it is minus I h bar jz. This minus minus plus, then I square minus. So we will be getting j square minus jz square minus h bar jz. So left hand side I am writing it as j square minus jz square minus h bar jz operating on ket jm is equal to right hand side am bm plus 1 jm. What is bm plus 1? Bm plus 1 equal to am star. So this bm plus 1 I can write it as am star. Am star is mod am square. So this is am b m plus 1 is am star. That I can write it as mod am square. So it is mod am square. Am square into ket jm. So operating j square with jm. will be having j into j plus 1 h bar square. First name is j into j plus 1 h bar square into ket jm. Ket jm I will write on right side. So minus j z square operating on jm. J z on jm, m h bar jm. Then 2 times, so we will be getting m square h bar square into ket jm. Then minus h bar into j z operating on jm, so it will be m h bar jm, so we will be getting m h bar square into ket jm. Ket jm equal to right hand side we are having a m square jm. A m square jm. Now I multiplying by bra jm on both sides, so we will be getting j into j plus 1 h bar square minus m square h bar square minus m h bar square into left hand side, it will be here we will be getting jm jm, so this will be 1, so into 1 equal to am square. Right hand side also we will be getting bra jm into ket jm, that will be 1. So it is am square into 1, or we are having am equal to, taking h bar square common, then it will be j into j plus 1, j square plus j minus m square minus m into h bar square. So I am rewriting this as am equal to j square minus m square, j square minus m square, then plus j minus m into h. Oh, actually it is am square, am square. Am means square root of this one. Am is square root of h bar square. I am writing h bar outside. H bar square is taken outside, so it will be into h bar. J root of j square minus m square, j minus m into j plus m. Then plus, this is j minus m into h bar, over am equal to root of, taking j minus m common, j minus m into j plus m plus 1 into h bar. So this is the value of am. In a similar way, we can calculate the value of bm. We can obtain the value of bm as bm equal to root of, bm can be obtained as root of j plus m into j minus m plus 1 into h bar. This is the value of bm. So we know that j plus jm, j plus jm equal to constant am into ket j m plus 1. So this can be written as j plus jm equal to am. Instead of am, we are having root of j minus m, j plus m plus 1 into h bar into j m plus 1. The matrix elements of j plus can be obtained by multiplying left side from left by j prime m prime, bra j prime m prime. So it can be written as j prime m prime j plus j m equal to, multiplying from left by j prime m prime, this is constant, so we can write root of j minus m into j plus m plus 1 h bar, then into, here it is j m plus 1, and from left we are multiplying by j prime m prime j m plus 1. What is bracket j prime m prime j m plus 1. It will be delta j prime j delta m prime m plus 1. So this can be written as delta j prime j delta m prime m plus 1. So this represents, this equation represents the matrix elements of j plus. J prime m prime represents the row and j m represents the column. So this is given by root of j minus m, j plus m plus 1 h bar. That means we will be having non-zero elements for j plus matrix when j prime equal to j. This is non-zero, right hand side is non-zero when j prime equal to j and m prime equal to m plus 1. So when m prime equal to m, this should be equal to 0. That means we don't have any elements on the diagonal points. So the non-zero elements will be present when j prime equal to j and m prime equal to m plus 1. In the case of j square and j z, we are having only elements in diagonals because there the condition is j prime equal to j and m prime equal to m. Here it is j prime equal to j but m prime equal to m plus 1. So m prime equal to m represents the diagonal elements. So here all the diagonal elements will be 0 since m prime equal to m plus 1. In a similar way, we can obtain the matrix elements of j minus s. I am writing here j prime, m prime, j minus, j m equal to root of bm. Bm is j minus, j plus m into j minus m plus 1 h bar. Then delta j prime j, then delta m prime, here it is m plus 1 and here we will be having m minus 1. So the non-zero elements will be present when j prime equal to j and m prime equal to m minus 1. So for j minus matrix, we will be having non-zero elements for j prime equal to j and m prime equal to m minus 1. And for j plus matrix, we will be having non-zero elements for j prime equal to j and m prime equal to m plus 1. So first we will draw the matrix elements of j plus. J plus, j m, that represents column, j prime, m prime, which represents the rows. So for j equal to 0, m equal to 0, here j prime equal to 0, m prime equal to 0, then j equal to 1 by 2, j prime equal to plus 1, sorry, m equal to plus 1 by 2 or minus 1 by 2, for j prime equal to 1 by 2, m prime equal to plus 1 by 2 or minus 1 by 2, then for j equal to 1, j prime equal to plus 1, 0, sorry, m equal to 1, 0, minus 1, for j equal to 1, j prime equal to 1, m prime can be 1, 0, minus 1. Now see the elements here. M, J all are 0, so here it will be 0. Then here J is 1 by 2 and J prime is 0. In this column J is 1 by 2, J prime is 0. Non-zero elements only when J prime equal to J. So here all the elements will be 0. All the elements will be 0. I am writing this all zeros. This in this one. So all the elements in that column will be 0. Here J is 1 and J prime is 0. J 1, J prime 0. That means J not equal to J prime. Here all the elements will be 0. Now in this column, J is 0, J prime is 1 by 2. So J not equal to J prime. So all the elements will be 0. Here on 0, 0. Then in this column, J 1, J prime, sorry, J 0, J prime 1. So here all the elements will be 0. In this column, here j 1 by 2 j prime 1, so all the elements will be 0. Now in this column j 1 j prime 1 by 2, so all the elements will be 0. So we will be having non-zero elements in this column and this one. Now we will find the elements in this column corresponding to j equal to 1 by 2 and j prime equal to 1 by 2. J equal to 1 by 2 and j prime equal to 1 by 2. So we can have non-zero elements. One more condition is there, m prime equal to m plus 1. So at this point, m is 1 by 2, m prime is 1 by 2. That means m prime equal to m. Non-zero value only when m prime equal to m plus 1. So here the value will be 0. At this point, m minus 1 by 2, m prime also minus 1 by 2. So at this point, m equal to m prime. So its value will be 0. Now at this point, see m and m prime. M is minus 1 by 2 and m prime is 1 by 2. M prime equal to 1 by 2 equal to minus 1 by 2 plus 1. Minus 1 by 2 plus 1 is plus 1 by 2. That means here we are having non-zero element where m prime equal to m plus 1. Now at this point, minus 1 by 2, 1 by 2. So here the condition is not satisfied. So here the element will be 0. We will be having non-vanishing element only at this point in this matrix. So what is the value at this point? Its value is given by j minus m into j plus m plus 1 square root into h bar. So it will be root of, its value will be root of, what is j? J is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 minus j minus m, m is minus 1 by 2. So minus 1 by 2 means plus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 plus m is minus 1 by 2 plus 1. So this will cancel. So it is 1. Then 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, 1. 1 into 1, 1. So it is root of 1 into h bar. That means this is, its value is h bar. So here it is h bar. Now see this column. Here also we can have non-zero elements, because j prime equal to j, then we will be having non-zero elements for m prime equal to m plus 1. We will identify the points where m prime equal to m plus 1. So here 9 elements will be there. We will find the non-zero elements in this matrix. This is a square matrix and we are having 9 components there. Now find the non-zero elements. Where we can have non-zero elements, m prime equal to m plus 1. At this point, m is minus 1. M plus 1 is 0. So here, minus 1, but m is 1. So this condition is not satisfied at this point. So we are having 0 there. Take this point. Here, m is 0. Then, m prime is 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. That means m prime equal to m plus 1. At this point, we can have non-zero value. What is the value there? At this point, root of j minus m. J is 1. Root of j minus m. J is 1 minus m is 0. Into 1 plus 0 plus 1. 1 plus j plus m plus 1 into h bar. So it will be 1 into 2. So it is root 2 h bar. So here we are having root 2 h bar. Now at this point m is 1 and m prime is 1. So m equal to m prime. Our condition is m prime equal to m plus 1. So here the element is 0. Here the element will be 0 because these are diagonal elements where m equal to m prime. Here also m equal to m prime. Here also m equal to m prime. Now at this point minus 1, m is minus 1, so minus 1 plus 1 0. Here it is 0. That means here m prime equal to m plus 1. So here also we will be having non-zero elements where m is minus 1. So its value we can find it as j minus m. J is 1. 1 minus minus 1. So it will be 1 plus 1. Into 1 j plus m. M is minus 1. So plus 1 into h bar. It is 2. 1 minus 1, 0 plus 1. 2 into 1. So it is root 2 h bar. Here also we are having root 2 h bar. Now at this point, m is 1. 1 minus 1, 0. Here it is m prime equal to m prime is. M prime is 0, M prime equal to, our condition M prime is equal to M plus 1. Here it is M prime equal to M minus 1. So here the condition is not satisfied, so it will be 0. Here also M prime equal to M plus 1 condition is not satisfied. Here also the element will be 0. So this matrix represents the elements of J plus matrix, where we will be having non-zero elements only in these matrices. Here it is 0, since J and M are 0. Here we can have non-zero elements in this matrix, because at this point we are having J prime equal to J. Here also J prime equal to J, so we are having non-zero elements in this matrix. So only in diagonal matrices we will be having non-zero elements, and that non-zero elements are present where M prime equal to M plus 1. In a similar way, we can calculate the matrix elements of J minus. How we can calculate the matrix elements of J minus? J minus, actually it is J prime equal to J and M prime equal to M minus 1. We will be having non-zero elements when J prime equal to J and M prime equal to M minus 1. So how can we write the matrix elements of J minus? J minus. If I write the matrix elements of J minus, then at this point, what is the condition? J prime equal to J and M prime equal to M minus 1. So here this is minus 1 by 2 and here it is 1 by 2. It is M plus 1, so this term will be 0. Here the term will be 0. I am writing J minus with blue ink, or I am writing with red ink. J plus is represented by black ink, and J minus, in the same matrix I am representing J minus by red ink. So J minus, here it will not be there, here it will be 0. Then at this point we will be having M is 1 by 2 and M prime is minus 1 by 2. 1 by 2 minus 1. 1 by 2 minus 1 is minus 1 by 2. So here the condition will be satisfied. In the case of J plus matrix, it is 0. In the case of J minus matrix, this term will be H bar. How can we find that value? It is J plus M into J minus M plus 1. J plus M. J plus M, J 1 by 2, 1 by 2. So it is 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, 1. Then 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2, 0 plus 1, 1. So it is root of 1 into h bar. So it will be h bar. So this represents this. In this column, we will be having J minus 4. J equal to 1 by 2. We will be having J minus matrix as 0, 0, h bar 0. This is J minus matrix. For J equal to 1 by 2. Now what about J equal to 1? So in this case, here the element will be 0. Here also the element will be 0, because M is 0 and M prime is 1. Our condition is M prime equal to M minus 1. So the condition is not satisfied at these two points. Now see this point here. At this point, M is 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0. This M prime is 0. So here the condition is satisfied. So when you calculate J plus M into J minus M, J is 1, M is 1. So it is 1 plus 1, 2 into 1 minus 1 plus 1, 2 into 1. So it is root 2 H bar. So here it will be root 2 H bar. At this point also, in J plus matrix it is 0, but in J minus matrix we will be having 0 for M. Then 0 minus 1 is minus 1. So here M prime equal to M minus 1 condition is satisfied at this point. Find the value at this point. Then at this point, the value will be j plus m. J is 1, m is 0. So 1 plus 0 into 1 minus 0 plus 1. So it is 2. So root 2 h bar. Here it will be root 2 h bar. That means when you write j minus matrix, in j minus matrix, this we will be having non-zero elements only at these two points. I am writing that matrix here. For j equal to 1, the j minus matrix will be, this matrix we can write it as 0, 0, 0, then root 2 h bar 0, 0, then here 0, root 2 h bar 0. So this represents the j minus matrix. This column we will be having only two, instead of drawing a separate figure, I have written both the elements here. J plus and J minus. This black represents J plus and red represents J minus. Only in J minus we will be having non-zero elements represented by the red color. Here when you draw J minus matrix, then it will be 0, this will be 0, this all will be 0. Now from this J plus and J minus matrices, we will find the values of Jx and Jy. Jx and Jy. Jx and Jy we can obtain as J plus equal to Jx plus Ijy and J minus equal to Jx minus Ijy. So adding these two and dividing by 2, we will get Jx. So 2Jx equal to J plus plus J minus, or Jx equal to half into Jx plus J minus, and Jy equal to, taking the difference, Ijy minus Ijy, it will be 2Ijy equal to J plus minus J minus. So divide by 2y. Dividing by I means, or we can write it as 1 by I is minus I. So minus I by 2 into J plus minus J minus will be Jy. So from this matrix we can draw the J plus matrix. J plus. Sorry, Jx. J plus is already drawn. I am drawing Jx. J, M, J prime, M prime. Here 0, 0, 1 by 2. 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, 1, 1, 0, minus 1 by 2. Here 0, 0. 1 by 2, 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, then 1, 1, 0, minus 1. Now Jx, Jx is J plus plus J minus by 2. J plus we are having H bar here, J minus we are having H bar here. So adding these two, J, this actually, this matrix represents J plus plus J minus. J plus plus J minus. Both are represented here. So, this H bar, here also H bar. So, now this matrix represents, this matrix represents J plus plus J minus. Both the elements are shown together there. So this represents J plus plus J minus. Then divide by 2, we will be getting Jx. So Jx we can draw it as J plus plus J minus by 2. I am drawing in this figure only. So adding and dividing by 2. That means here we will be getting H bar by 2. Here also H bar by 2. This one is root 2 h bar by 2. It will be h by root 2. H by root 2. Root 2 h bar by 2. It will be h by root 2. Root 2 h bar by 2 is h bar by root 2. Here also h bar by root 2. So this represents the matrix elements of Jx. This is the matrix elements of Jx. Now, what is the matrix element for j equal to 1 by 2, the value of jx. For j equal to 1 by 2, the value of jx is represented by jx equal to 0, h bar by 2, h bar by 2, 0. Taking h bar by 2 common, we can write it as jx equal to h bar by 2 into 0, 1, 1, 0. This is jx. Now, how can we find jy? Jx is jx plus j minus by 2. Now, for finding jy is minus I by 2. Minus I by 2 into jx minus, sorry, j plus minus j minus. So, j plus minus j minus by 2. J plus plus j minus by 2 is represented by this one. So, j plus minus j minus by 2. This is the element for j plus and this is the element for j minus. So, taking the difference, when you calculate that, you will be getting minus h bar by 2 here. Then here it will be plus h bar by 2. This h bar by root 2 is for j plus. So, here also we will be getting h bar by root 2. This one will be, when you minus it, then it will be minus h bar by root 2. Here also minus h bar by root 2. Then, taking the difference by 2, you will be getting a matrix like this. Then multiplied by minus I. When I multiply by minus I, so this will be minus I. Minus I. Multiplying by minus I, this will be plus I. Then this is minus I, then this will be plus I, this one will be minus I, this one will be plus I. So this represents the matrix elements of JY. So this equation represents the matrix elements of JY, and we can write for J equal to 1 by 2, for J equal to 1 by 2, what is the matrix element? For jy, this is 0 minus I h bar by 2, I h bar by 2, 0. From this, if I take h bar by 2 common, then it will be h bar by 2 into 0 minus I, 0. So, this represents the matrix element for jy. Then this one, this column for j equal to 1, for j equal to 1, you will be getting a matrix like this. So these are the matrix elements for j plus, j minus, jx and jy. Thank you.